War II. Suzanne Spaak gave her life to save hundreds of Jewish children in Nazi-occupied Paris. She set up an underground network to keep them in hiding and joined an intelligence-gathering organisation to fight German oppression. Well, earlier I spoke with Anne Nelson, the author of Suzanne's Children, to learn more about the resistance. There are many stories about people helping Jews under Nazi occupation. What made Suzanne so special?
She was a woman who lived at a time when she had very few official possibilities. She couldn't vote. She couldn't open a bank account with her own money without her husband's permission. And yet she undertook this incredible task of organizing a network of people to rescue Jewish children from Auschwitz. She and her network offer a model for how resistance can address abusive governments for all time.
Resistance is something we hear an awful lot about today. What lessons do we learn from her?
Well, first of all, if she could have voted, she would have voted. She really believed in the democratic process. She only took this extraordinary action when there was no democratic process that was available. The other thing was that it wasn't a narrow resistance. It wasn't the wonderful job of hiding a Jewish family in your basement. Many people did that. But first of all, she went and found the people who needed her help the most. And they happened to be Polish Jews in Paris, even though she wasn't Polish and she wasn't Jewish. The first thing they did was get information out. There was this wall of propaganda coming from the Nazis and the Vichy government. They put out newsletters, they told people what was actually going on. The second thing was that they found the most vulnerable populations, and often abusive governments go for them the first. These were immigrants. They were defenseless immigrants. They were poor. And they helped them. They saved their lives.
What difference did she make, given the scale of the Jewish Holocaust?
She was involved in creating a network that rescued, one estimates, perhaps 500 Jewish children. There were other adults. There aren't hard figures available for this. And within the scale of the Holocaust in France, it was considerable.
Do we know what happened to those children?
I've been able to trace a fair number of them, and I've interviewed three or four of them. They grew up to be professionals, they had good lives, they had good families. They carried the trauma with them, but they've also made a real contribution to the world.
What do you think inspired Suzanne and kept her going? Because she was, of course, executed. She gave her life for this.
She had been disappointed, to put it mildly, by her marriage, which was terrible. And this made her useful. She was important, and the qualities she had were badly needed. So here she was, this woman who had been marginalized and treated badly, and all of a sudden she could be of use. And that transformed her.
You met her daughter. How much of a help was that?
I interviewed her daughter, who is now around 90, probably 30 times, and her son about 5 times. And it was extraordinary. The daughter has this crystalline memory of the occupation, not only the important events of the rescue, but the day-to-day life. And capturing that flavor of Paris was really important to me in the writing of the book.
Anne Nelson, thank you very much indeed for joining me.
Thank you.